guys, welcome again. In last video, I have already discussed about the user interface, some basic user interface. Now in this, I just opened the sample project and I will just guide you how I will open this. There is in the start window, it will show sample architectural project. So I will just mouse left click button. So you have to press just mouse left click and it will open this sample project. When you open this sample project, it will open like this on the title sheet you will find here. Now, what we are gonna discuss? We are gonna discuss about this user interface in detail with the help of this sample project. So we will easy and we are able to understand the use and after effects with the help of project browser and properties, how we are gonna use. So let's start. Now, when we open this, it will open in this sheet and you find that architectural options, these all the options are disabled. You cannot even able to select them. Why? Because this comes with the open the sheet. Now, how we will withdraw, how we will change from this? If you gonna check about this project browser, on the right hand side, there is a window named as project browser. In this project browser, you will scroll this one and below this, you will find here the sheets. In the sheets, you will find A001 title sheet. This is the this sheet is already opened. If you gonna click on this site plan, double click on it, it will open this site plan sheet. This is our site plan. Now again, go to the plans, double click on this. So this will shows all the sheets here. And that's why these are the architectural tabs. These are all the options are disabled. Now what you are gonna do, you will gonna come in this option, floor plans. We just scrolled upward in the project browser. There is option floor plans. In the floor plans, we will find level 1 and level 2. So we just double click on level 1. When you double click on this level 1, you will find some color legend for the rooms, in which with the help of colors, it is divided in the category wise. Like this is the living area, this is kitchen and dining area, this is hall, bathroom, mechanical services like shaft and all, and this is the laundry area. So according to the color, these areas are divided with the help of room legend. They are all showing here. Now this is the level 1, this is the floor plan for level 1. Suppose level 1 is the ground and level 2 is the roof, so you can check the level 2. Just double click on level 2. This is the floor plan for level 2. Again, you will find here the room legend. So this is how you can segregate, you can mention the differences, and you can highlight the areas with the dimensions, tags, text and color legends. So this is the floor plan, and when you click on this floor plan, you will find that all the options are enabled. Now you can work with the wall now, and you can create the walls, and now you can use the door option. Suppose you want to put door anywhere, you can click on the door options, it will implement here. Now first we will select and delete. We are gonna discuss about this sample project. So these are the floor plans. When you want to check or when you want to create, you can switch from this project browser level 1 if you click on level 1. Now when you will jump to this floor plan level 1, it will show you all the level 1 floor plans, and in the property tab it will show the properties of this level 1 floor plan. All the properties comes under here, because no component, no family, no object is selected till now. That's why it will shows the properties of this floor plan. Suppose I am gonna use the middle mouse button is the scroll. With the help of scroll, you can zoom in and zoom out. Zoom in when you move the upward, this is zoom in, and when you move the downward, this is zoom out. So you can click, you can change, zoom in and zoom out with the help of middle mouse button. So after zoom in, we will find there is a door. If we click on this door, now this door is selected. Now what you will see in the property tab, it will shows all the property, all the details about this door which you already selected. So property tab change according to your selection. Suppose you are gonna select this window. This is a sink offset, color vault steel stainless sink. So if you select this, the properties tab shows the property of this. If you are gonna select this wall, you select this wall, this is a curtain wall. Now in the properties, you will find all about this curtain wall. Now this curtain wall base constraint is level 1, like wall is started from this level up to ceiling level. The total height is 2700 mm. Now in the property tab, you will find all about the selected components. If you do not select any component, property tab shows the property of the view, like views like of the floor plan, of the 3D view or elevation. Now if you want to switch to the elevation with the help of project browser, you can switch the views. Suppose you gonna check about the south elevation, so you can double click on this south elevation and you will come to this south elevation window. Here in the elevation, you will find all the levels. This is level 1 at 0, this is level 2 at 3000, and this is the roof line. So these are all are the levels. Now this is the foundation, this is the level 1 living room. These all are the created here. Now if you want to check them in 3D, if you want to check this model in the 3D, how you will want? There are various options, like in the quick access toolbar, you will find this default 3D view. You can click on here, default 3D view, or I'm gonna click on level 1 again. In the 3D views here in the project browser, you will find 3D here. Just double click on it, 3D, it will find this. Now with the help of middle mouse button, you can zoom in and zoom out. With the help of while pressing shift plus middle mouse button, both at the same time, shift and middle mouse button, you can drag the mouse. It will help in orbiting. You will able to rotate this at any angle. You can zoom in and zoom out while pressing shift and scroll. You are able to rotate this. This is known as orbit. So you can use this orbit command while pressing the shift and middle mouse button. So shift plus middle mouse button, you can use orbit command. So in 3D, you will find every component which whatever you inserted, either that is site, either that is 3D model, elevation, floor plan, 3D views, sections, elevations, everything you will find there in project browser. Now if you want to check does this section, stair section, you can double click on it. There you will find this stair section. Now where is this stair section? If we go to the floor plan, you will find there is a section, this one. This is the section view. So with the help of this, you will find this view. Now if you double click on here, you will also find the 3D view. Okay, there are the three sections. Type wall section, you will find this wall sections is. Now comes below, there are some camera settings like approach, already some camera sets by the viewer. Now from here you can go to this realistic. This is the visual style option. You can use this visual style option. This is very helpful in giving you the idea about the 3D model or the material effect. Now let's suppose, now this will take some time maybe. So we just got the view. This is the realistic view. Now if you go to this living room, we can double click on the living room and we will find this living room here. This is again the shaded comes. You can click on here and you can go to the realistic view. This will again take some time. So when you switch to the realistic view, in realistic view there is a effect of material with texture, edges and everything you will find in the realistic view. So from here you can change your visual styles. In this we have some renders. drawings. So if we go to for the render, for the 3D view 1 we have some render files. From yard we have a render. For the kitchen we have a single render file. For the living room we have a render file. And this is the perspective view. These are the render views which you will render, or you can export them with to share or to present your project. Now after this, you can make, you are able to make some schedules according to your site, according to your components. Now first we will go for the planting schedule. Here we have some plants we use. Honey locust, we use 8 number of honey locust. So we find these schedules. We can create like wall schedule, room schedules according to the requirement. Now from the schedules again we can go for the sheets which we are able to print. This is the title sheet, this is the site plan, simple floor plans, elevations and sections. We will find elevation sections detail, and we will find the stairs details, stair section details. So this is how we can set, we can all set all the sheets according to our project. We can print them. We will go at the site. We will explain everything to our site engineer with the help of these sheets. So can site engineer help? Site engineer is able to understand all the details of the project and easy to convey to their juniors all the details, and also share all the details with the project manager and update them each and everything. So this is how you can create all the project tasks. You can do all type of project work in Revit. I think this is for the demo class today. Now in the next lecture we will start from the scratch. We will start with the scratch. So in the next lecture we are gonna start with the metric template, and in the first lecture we will understand all about the how we will create the grids and levels to our project. So I hope everything is clear. If you like this video, please share, like, subscribe. If you have any doubts, please comment me below. I will definitely reply you, and I will try to explain each and every query regarding this course. Okay guys, thank you so much. So we will discuss in the next video. Okay guys, thank you.